In this tutorial, we'll show you how to create data maps and move data from planning applications to strategic models. With Smart Push enabled, you can now push data between planning and strategic models using a UI-driven data mapping process and data transfer functionality that does not require scripting. Let's begin by creating a data map. You create data maps to map dimensions between a source planning application, strategic model, or strategic consolidation model, and a target planning application, reporting application, or strategic model. Enter a unique name for your data map. Descriptions are optional. Then, select the source and target. In this example, I'm selecting the OEP underscore FS cube in my planning application as my source, and my financials underscore SM strategic model as my target. Next, I'll start mapping my source and target dimensions. Click the Select link under each dimension to open Member Selector. You can enter a search criteria to find members or navigate and click members from the member list. Additional options can be found in Settings. I'll quickly complete member selections for a few dimensions. For the time dimension in my strategic model, I'll need to map two dimensions, years and period. An additional source mapping is required to complete this task. Then, I'll select members. Optionally, on this page, you can leave member selections at the default or root level and specify mappings in the Edit Data Map dialog box. For each dimension, you can click the Map link to open the Edit Data Map dialog box. Let's walk through the tabs in the Edit Data Map dialog box. Basic info includes the name and description of your data map. It also lists the source and target. Source selection displays a filtered point of view of your source members. Here are the dimensions with members I've selected. Target selection displays your target member options. Notice that account lists members at the root level. When you change member selections, you must apply the same change on the map tabs and the source and target selection tabs. I'll also make sure that my member mappings are consistent between the dimension tabs and the source and target selection tabs. When selecting members, you can use the drop-down list to select from a filtered list. The contents of the filtered list are based on selections on these two tabs. Similarly, I'll enter mappings for scenario. Let's take a look at my accounts. Data maps automatically map same name dimension members and allows you to define the mapping between other dimension members. You can define complex mappings to or from a single member, to or from multiple members. After I selected source account members, the system identifies, checks, compares, and selects account names in the target. While auto-mapping can be a time saver, you can still make changes to the target selections in this tab. Because I have my target selection for accounts set to the root level, I can choose from all the accounts available in my model. For years and period, I mapped a combination of source planning years and period dimension members to the model's time dimension. You can also map multiple periods to a single time period and specify the aggregation to use. For example, you can map January through December to a single time period in the model. Unmapped dimensions are read-only in this dialog box. If you need to make changes to unmapped dimensions, close this dialog box and make your selections here. I'll quickly select members for the unmapped dimensions. You can also make additional changes to your mappings here. Here are the updated mappings. Here's my source, target, and the number of members mapped per dimension. After making changes, save and close the data map. Here's my data map. The Actions menu allows you to edit, duplicate, delete, or synchronize the data map and clear and push data using your data map selections. Let's take a look at the source and target POV we'll be working with before pushing data. Here is the data point of view of my source planning application. Here is the target point of view in my strategic model. Now, I'll return to the data maps page and run Smart Push. Here's my data map. I'll open the Actions menu for my data map and select Clear and Push Data. Smart Push always clears data in the target region before moving new data. A confirmation message is displayed. I'll open the model to verify that the data was moved successfully. Data was successfully moved to my strategic model. After creating a data map, you can export it to a file make changes to it using Excel, and import it back into your application to update your existing data. Or you can modify the data map name in the file, make changes to your selections, save it with a new file name, then import it into your application as a new data map. The exported file displays tabs similar to the Edit Data Map dialog box. For more information on importing data maps, visit the Oracle Planning and Budgeting Cloud Help Center and view the Using Excel Data Maps for Moving Data Between Planning Cubes and Strategic Models tutorial. In this tutorial, you learned how to create data maps and move data from planning applications to strategic models. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.